Welcome, everybody. Welcome to this channel.
Yeah, welcome anybody that's new. No matter where you might be, we've found that we have people watching us from all over, which still kind of, you know, surprised at, but we love to have you. We love to have all of you that come back and watch our videos. We're really happy that, I know I said happy a lot, didn't I?
It feels like an extended family.
Yeah.
Does that cover it all?
It just makes us happy that you guys are enjoying them and maybe getting some information.
Hope so.
Yeah, because we definitely learn something every single time, and we really like to be able to pass it on to you. Well, forget about all that. This video.
Don't forget it.
Well, I mean, let's move on. Okay, let's move on. So this video, it is about an American character, Tiny Tears. Mm-hmm. And she was one of the dolls that we got when we went to our secondhand store and brought everybody along with us. And my goodness, she was in excellent condition. She was in better condition than I thought.
She was, except for her eyes.
Well, yeah, her eyes had a little bit of a problem.
And her hair needed a lot of help.
She fixed them. She did.
I did. They were rock by eyes. The first ones I ever did.
Right. Well, let's not spoil it. Let's just get to one thing.
What?
You found an absolutely adorable outfit for her.
Yes. Yes. She looks.
So you might want to watch it to the end. Because this one,
she really looks adorable.
She does. So let's just get to it. Ready? Here we go.
Hello, everybody. I'm a Tiny Tears from the middle 50s.
Mm-hmm.
I have hard plastic head and a vinyl body.
Mm-hmm.
15 inches tall and made by American Character.
Right. Oh, she's 15 inches?
Yes.
And she has Saran hair, and it's a dark brown.
Yes.
And she's actually, you might remember her from one of our other videos. She was one of the dolls that we found at a secondhand store with all those other dolls.
And her eye was turned up into her head a little.
Yeah, you could see that in this picture right here. So we're going to have to remove her
head. And to do that, this is a rice bag and it's hot.
Mm-hmm.
So I will lay her in there till her vinyl warms up. And when that vinyl warms up, then I'll remove her head.
Well, I think we ought to do it.
Oh, okay. Well, we removed her head.
But we will show everybody how we get it back on.
Yes. So
what did you do?
Well, it was rattling in there. And this is what we found. And my husband was with me because he helped me take her head off. I asked him what that was. He didn't know. I didn't know either. But I saw a hole here that was extra.
I don't think that there are extra anything in these dolls, honey.
As far as
except in their heads when they have, you know, needles and, oh, and of course, bottle brushes.
Bottle brushes.
Those can be extra.
Well, I figured that was one of those things.
Ah.
So I didn't know what it was, but then I remembered, oh, yes, they make noise so that they can blow bubbles. So we figured out what that was.
Very cute. We finally have one that actually squeaks.
Well, the other one we sold squeaked too.
No, I'm talking about we have some with the cry box, and we tried very hard to get those little girls to cry again, and no such luck.
Well, what we found with her eye is she's a rockabye, which I had never seen the mechanism for a rockabye.
Hmm.
And see, her eyes are open, but if you rock her, they close. And there is, oh shoot, I don't have my
trusty skewer.
Yes. Do you see this metal piece?
Mm-hmm.
It looks like it's got teeth in it. Well, when I looked at that, my husband looked at that. We said, what the heck is that? And it's bent. And of course, we hadn't seen one before. So when I turned her back up, her eyes opened and they were normal.
Not wonky anymore.
Not wonky anymore. What's going on? I thought I had his job of fixing her eyes. So what happens is that her eyes, as soon as you pick her up from sleep, and they stay, they, when you lay her down, they stay open. But when you rock her, her eyes go to sleep. But then somebody walks in the room and she sticks her head up and there she goes.
So you think it's going to stay that way once you put her head back on?
Yes. And the reason we think so is you don't want any moisture in here at all, even though it was a tiny tears, because all the, a lot of these rubber hoses have rotted that would go down in here. And so I could replace it, but I think it's safer for these old dolls not to have water put in them. So what he did, let's rock you to sleep. What we did is he said he had a kind of a grease that was had no liquid in it. And so I took a tiny little tad of, because her eye was stuck on it.
Mm-hmm.
So we
stuck on what?
On this.
Mm.
And so I took a tiny little, not even a drop, and I put it in here where the teeth are.
Mm-hmm.
And boy, does her mechanism work well now. I don't have to worry about putting her head back on and not having it, you know, stick.
Mm-hmm.
It won't stick.
So is there anything else that we need to look at inside this miss?
No, actually, her her insides are perfect. Absolutely perfect. Her eyes are perfect. Everything's perfect. So here we go. This is nice and warm, hot.
Well, let's explain to everybody what this is.
This is a rice bag. Here's the rice. This is the rice in...
Just a sheet.
It's a sheet, but there are pockets. See the pockets? That's from water. I let water get on it to get the rice to have moist heat sometimes. I'll just drop some water. Anyway.
We warmed it up in the microwave.
We use these for our pain that we have. And so we warm it up in the microwave, and every microwave warms differently, and every it all depends on the amount of rice you have in it and all that kind of thing, what how much time you would leave it in.
Okay, so you're going to let that get warm.
I'm going to warm up.
For about how long?
5 minutes.
Okay, so we'll come back. It won't be 5 minutes for you, but it'll definitely be 5 minutes for us. So here we go. See, I told you it wouldn't be that long.
Yes. So we are going to unwrap her, and yes, her neck is really warm, and I put her little squeaker back in. So this is what we're going to do.
And it wouldn't be that easy if...
No, if it wasn't malleable.
It wasn't warmed up by the...
There you go! Evie can't carry it around anymore. Go. She's got her head back on.
Yep.
And Evie can't pick it up anymore.
Let's not.
So what the next thing I am going to do with this little lady?
Well, she's going to get a bath.
She will get a bath, and I will use the hand cleaner.
Well, it looks like it's time for her bath.
Yes, she's going to get a bath with this hand cleaner. Some people use Goop, and not that I couldn't use Goop. I love this one. It's got aloe and contains lemon.
And it doesn't have a whole lot of a scent?
No, and it's easier. It's because I'm allergic.
We tolerate it.
Yeah, we tolerate it much better. So whatever you guys choose to use is fine.
And you're using this because she's vinyl?
Yes, but I've also
well, because it's not the same that we do on hard plastic.
It wouldn't hurt hard plastic. I even used it on compo, but I wipe it off instantly. So I use it on a lot of things, but differently for each. Depends on what you're using it for. She's got a little mark on the back of her hand. I'll have to take that off separately.
So you're putting it on and you are essentially wiping it right off.
Well, for her, because she's vinyl, I don't have to wipe it right off. If it was a compo, I would, absolutely.
So is it just cleaning her or is it also conditioning her?
It's doing a little both for the vinyl. I use, actually, on compo, I use it on the inside more than I do on
the outside. What about her face?
Her face is, you can use it on hard plastic. Her face is hard plastic.
So are we going to clean it with that, or are we going to clean it with a Mr. Clean?
Mr. Clean.
Ah, well, I think we ought to go do that.
Well, here she is, nice and clean, and you can see that she was dirty. She would have been much dirtier if she hadn't been wearing her vintage one piece. So
let's clean her face.
Let's do her face. But it isn't real dirty. I don't think. I do see some dirt up here. I just like having a mildly wet,
damp
Mr. Clean.
Gee, I've said that before and she told me,
no,
it's wet.
Yeah, it is. It is wet, but it's not dripping wet.
So then it's damp.
And it's not. It's a little more than damp, but we're not. Yeah. We're not going to argue over words.
I think that I was right.
Because it works better, of course, when it's wet. She has a little mark right there. And you have to be very careful around her eyebrows, her mouth, her cheeks. That spot, that light spot was there. And she's not really extremely dirty on her face. Oh, there's some dirt.
Okay. Well, she's going to finish getting her face washed. And I think next we're going to go wash this cute little lady's hair.
It's really done. And I want to show them what I'm going to do with her one piece. This is a little vintage outfit because people have asked about that. And this is a little pair of pajamas with a little button in the back.
Mm-hmm.
And I want them to see all these strings from on the seams and all. And what I do is I just trim those seams, strings. It means say so. I just trim the strings because you don't want to trim off the fabric, because if you do, you could get too close to the seam and then have a problem. So what I do, see, I just make sure that all of the threads are up so I can cut them.
Okay.
And then you do that with the entire doll outfit. And it just looks so much nicer. And I'm going to oxy-clean this, and then I will iron it.
Sounds like a plan. Well, I haven't seen that in a while.
She's already.
Well, she kind of...
You dropped your whale? Oh my goodness.
That kind of suits her.
What? The whale or the bathtub?
The bathtub. We haven't had a rub-a-dub in there before.
No, she looks like a rub-a-dub dolly a little bit. Oh no, some people could get mad at me for that one. But rub-a-dub was when you were a little.
No, it wasn't. It was definitely before me.
It was before you? But you had one.
No, Renee did.
Renee had one?
I'd never.
Or I got it at a garage sale.
Probably, because it's before my time, hon.
I did a lot of garage sailing. Okay. Go by what she has to say, because she would know. I wouldn't.
All right. So, if you have seen our videos, you've seen this part, and if you don't want to watch it, just go right through it.
Fast forward.
But this young lady is going to get her hair washed with some soap. And she's going to get it conditioned with some softener for clothes.
And can I tell them why I use softener for clothes?
While you're washing.
Okay. We had some gels that I had gotten, and I called the manufacturer.
What she means secondhand.
Yeah, secondhand. And I called the manufacturer because I wanted to restore their hair. And the manufacturer, Madam Alexander, talked to me. They actually talked to me on the phone. And then they sent me the email on how to, that we should use laundry softener.
This is just soap, by the way.
Yeah, this is just soap.
Diluted soap.
Yes, diluted. And she said that is the way to restore synthetic hair. So that's why we use it, because a Dow manufacturer in their Dow repair department told me that's how they do it.
Okay, so we're not going to just waste too much of your time. She's going to get it all soaked up. It's going to get rinsed with the water. And then we're going to put some of the water, not water. Why do I always think water? The laundry softener on her hair, just like this. We're going to rinse it off.
Soft and gel downy is what we use.
Yeah. And then we're going to continue with her hair.
Right. Well, I went through and I combed out her hair with a metal large tine comb.
Mm-hmm.
Worked really well, especially with that conditioner. And but to do what I'm going to do, which is curl her hair or straighten it or repair it, whichever you want to call it,
I don't really think it's going to curl it.
No, it doesn't really curl it.
Because what she's talking about is she's going to use a curling iron, almost like a flat iron.
Yes.
But there are a couple of things you need to realize when you do this. If you've seen our videos before, you've heard this before. But if you haven't, this is Saran hair, and it is wet. That sound you just heard is the water hitting the heat. One of the other things you need to know is that this iron, it's a very small one, and as you can see here, it has a digital
readout
temperature gauge,
mm-hmm.
and it's on 160. And you do not want to go above 160. Not a good idea. Another thing that you have done in order to repair Saran with a iron is you do not leave.
Let go of this.
Yeah.
And clamp down.
Nope, it does not clamp down on the hair.
You don't want to do that because
it just sort of slides over
it. I just slide over it.
Kind of like
a flat iron.
Flat iron.
So,
and it's repairing the hair. It is not.
You can see right there.
Mm-hmm. The difference.
The difference between this
mm-hmm.
and this.
Now, I have a Tiny Tears, and she is essentially the same as this little girl, only her hair is a different color. And her hair was a Brillo pad.
Yeah.
And everything we did to try and soften her hair did not work.
No, but
until you discovered
this.
Yes. And did you see she just put on more water? You want the hair to be wet, not just damp. You want it to be wet because you do not want, you're not aiming to burn the fibers.
No.
It's only supposed to
repair them.
Mm-hmm. And you can only do that if it's wet.
Because that's what they do at factories. That's how they get these hair to have a memory to do this,
mm-hmm.
is because they put it on under extreme heat. And that's why you have some dolls with some certain styles and others that are curly styles, others that are just, light curl,
mm-hmm.
or the ones that are just straight. They use heat. They use heat, and some people pour really hot water on their dolls after they've got them in the curlers. And I did try that. I found it did not do what this does. So I don't do that method.
Now you'll have to understand that when she first tried this, she was scared.
Actually, it took me about over a year after I heard about it before I had the guts. And we got a doll and we called her Scary Spice because her hair was so bad.
She had saran hair.
She had saran hair and it was so bad. She made her look scary. And I couldn't do anything with it. Nothing I did. And I says, well, it should see the trash can or...
Well, she needs the hair, not the doll.
Yeah. Or give it a shot. And I gave it a shot. And I had... When I put her online after I'd restored her hair, I remember especially a gentleman saying, how did you do that? I can't get my saran hair to do what I wanted to do. You know, he couldn't repair it. And at that point, I was afraid to tell anybody that I was using an iron. Because a lot of people have said, don't ever, ever, ever do that.
See the difference between this hair.
Actually, this one can use some more.
And that hair. And we're not going to spend any more time on this. She's just going to continue doing
so
this.
So I used a small tine because I noticed that I did not get this out of this. And so I went back and I straightened out the hair some more because it's all damaged. And went back and redid it.
Okay. So she's going to continue getting her hair ironed. And are you going to curl it?
I haven't decided whether I'm going to curl. I want to see what happens after I iron it.
Okay, so.
Saran can go back to its memory.
Right.
Once you've ironed it, just comb it and then it'll go right back to its own memory.
All right, so she's going to continue with her day at the beauty parlor.
Well, here is her hair. It's soft and not brillo-y anymore.
Let's see all of it.
Oh, sure.
Very shiny.
Yes, isn't it pretty? And it combs beautifully.
Let's see.
Want to see it comb beautifully? Look, just goes through just nice.
And you didn't put any curlers in it?
No curlers, no. But I did do some little clips. What do you call those clips?
Alligator clips.
Yeah, alligator clips, and because it had been rolled back mm-hmm. the way it wasn't supposed to be for so long, as it was wet, I just laid them a clip here, a clip here, and I just used the clips till it dried.
Okay.
So that's how we got that.
So she did not, she came with a cute little sleeper, which
yes,
is vintage.
Which is vintage and will be restored.
But we're actually going to give her a dress.
Yes.
Now, is it a vintage dress?
I can't really tell you if this is vintage or not.
It doesn't look
not.
Vintage to me.
It depends on where the vintage begins.
Yeah.
I found some eyelet and I put this eyelet on it. And it also had a bad lace up here as well. And so I took some scraps of lace that I had. Actually, we used it on that one dress that was for the winter.
Mm.
And so I added that. And I'm going to add...
We really use our scraps.
We do.
Unless it is like an inch or so long, we save them.
Well, sure, because you can make, I didn't do this. This was originally on the dress. You can make little, mm-hmm. you know, decorations out of lace, not right. just ribbon.
So what are you going to do to finish her dress?
Okay, so here's a little tip that I thought people might like. You notice I use this when I...
I really like these water bottles. We get them from Hobby Lobby.
Okay, so I needed something this about this circumference. And so I want to, instead of... I showed you one tip, which was going in and out, in and out, in and out, with elastic lace.
No, elastic thread.
Thread, that's right. I'm going to elastic lace. Okay, there's such a thing as elastic lace.
Yes, this particular very, very, very fine lace I found on Etsy.
So what I do with this...
We'll show them how it is a little bit elastic.
Oh.
Oh, it's more than a little bit.
Yes, it has very nice elasticity.
And it's very small, and that's hard to find.
It is. And so instead of going on the inside, I'm going to, which I've done on dresses that I've even sold, so I've done it on the outside. So what I'm going to do is just take the two ends and join them together, sew them, and then I'm going to go over this bottle. So I'm going to make a little rubber band out of it, and then I'm going to go over and make that rubber band go around this whole thing and pull it in. It'll pull it all in like that. And then I am going to hand stitch it on with one thread. So I made my rubber band out of the elastic. So I'm going to come over here.
Gee, she's helping.
She sure is.
Usually we have four-legged helpers.
Yeah, and I've got my thread in the way. Hold that, could you? Thank you.
I multitask a lot.
Yes. And see, it makes it much easier if I don't have to worry about the thread. So what I did was I just go around, bring that area that is sewn together on the seam. It flare out.
So let me get a really good view of what you're doing.
See?
There we go.
See what I'm doing here? Okay. And spreading it out a little bit, right? Now give me that needle. And since it's right here at the I'm just going to reinforce by going through the fabric. And the elastic at the same time at the seam. And of course, I'm hitting a dead end here somewhere. That means I'm hitting a bunch of seam. There it goes.
I've noticed that your needle is kind of bent.
Well, that's because I put it through hell. And I want to do one more. And then I'll show you what I do. And I'm going to seal that. Okay. Now, what am I going to do? I'm going to do similarly to what I did with the elastic thread. Only this won't be elastic thread. And don't catch on those little bubbles, please. And I'm going to come down here to a V. It'll just make a V. As if you are zigzagging so that it allows the stretch. And it allows the, to open and close. You don't want to stretch the sleeve.
Yep, I think we got the point.
And so.
You didn't laugh.
I didn't get stuck. If I'd have got stuck, I'd have got the point. But I didn't get stuck, so.
Well, I think you ought to go faster.
Well, that's okay for you.
Yeah, well, see, I can make you go faster.
That's good.
Well, let's do it.
Well, here's the before.
Mm-hmm.
And here's the after.
Mm-hmm. And you didn't have to take out the original elastic.
And I did not take out the original elastic. I try not to to compromise its originality. You know what it originally was too much. I just kind of give it a new little spark.
Mm-hmm. So, what else are we going to do with this lovely little dress?
Well, since I took off this lace that was on the bottom here, and I took off the little bit of lace there, and I added this to the waist, to the high waist, I'm going to put a trim right here.
Should we see it?
We could.
That's a familiar little lace, not lace, little trim.
Well, I thought I'd use this because she's just not going to have the dress and panties that match the pink. And
don't tell them, it's a surprise.
No, it's a surprise. But she's got something else that's going to really set it over the top.
Yep.
And so this little bit of trim will be on something else that's quite...
You will see it in her reveal.
That is a vintage, and you'll see it in her reveal, and she'll have her original pajamas.
Mm-hmm.
She's going to be one cute little girl. So there are her matching panties. She'll have her trim, and here are uncleaned. They're not cleaned yet. They have not been oxy-cleaned or ironed. Oh, there's a little piece of it. But I did go through, and as you can see, I took care of all the seams as far as all the extra threads.
Mm-hmm.
And how nice.
So really quickly, I just wanted to show everybody, this little lady is in the early, probably the earliest version of Tiny Tears.
It is.
And if you can see her arms, her arms are made of rubber. And they're very, very fragile at this point because
from here to here, she is rubber. Yes. And we bought her, and then the lady called up and canceled because she was putting the doll in a jacket that was way too small.
And one of her fingers came off.
And so we told her, do you have a finger? Send the doll.
Right. So, but I want you to see that this little girl does not have a rubber body, even though she's only a couple of years different than this girl.
Right.
This one has a caracule wig, mm-hmm. which it is, that means that it is a...
It's a lamb pelt.
It's a lamb pelt. And this little girl has
a saran wig.
Yep. And...
And it's rooted.
But I wanted everybody to understand that with her body, you're not going to worry about anything breaking off.
No.
With this little girl, they can. So if you have one in this age range, be very, very careful of their limbs because you can lose body parts because the rubber is, it hasn't aged as well as it could.
Rubber deteriorates.
Right.
That's just so.
I just thought everybody would like to know the difference.
And this is what my little girl looked like that I got.
Right. This little one is, if you want to see it, is in one of our shorts.
Yes.
Okay. I think that perhaps we should go see her reveal. What do you think?
Could I mention this? These are, usually you see them with a big roll of lace. It's all ruffled. And I didn't have shoes to fit her. So, but the socks fit her, but I didn't like that ruffle.
Okay.
So I took that off, put that tiny little lace on it, mm-hmm. and gave her these.
Very cute.
For booties. So you can, I'm just giving people little tips for.
Yep. So Evie, do you think we should go see the reveal? Do you think so?
I don't think she's going to do it.
You do? You think we should? Okay, let's go.
Well, she almost looks angelic. I think she does. I think she came out wonderfully.
Can you believe that she was in the state she was and now she looks like this?
No, I never do believe it. It's always a surprise.
Well, but you had these things. I can't believe that you had them. I mean, yes, you worked on the dress and you did put a little bit of trim on her little bitty cape. But really, you had these things. You must have a treasure trove.
I really don't. It can't. I don't know where this basic part of the dress came from. I just made it the cotton dress look beautiful. That's all. But I don't remember how I got it or where it came from.
Okay, well, let's see what she looks like with her hood down. Well, that's cute too.
Yes, her hair came out really nice.
Yes, it did. And we don't usually do a big bow in the front, but I kind of like it with this little one. Look how soft her hair looks.
That is a vintage cape that came with another doll I had, but I chose her clothes that I wanted to put on my doll. And
these were extra.
These were extra.
Mm-hmm.
Well, that's because they always belonged to her. I just didn't know it.
That's right.
We just met her a few days ago.
Well, there's your dress.
Yeah, I didn't have much hope for that dress. I thought it was going to the trash bin.
I guess not.
I've done that so many times.
I mean, do you know how many times that I have told her, guess what, this would sell? And she says, no, it won't sell. It just, you know, just throw it away. And what sold?
I'll give you a little trim and a little bit of time to do some hand sewing.
Well, I think she looks absolutely lovely. Well, she's got some friends.
Yes. And they're all from a different part of this same decade.
They are. So tell us about the first one.
The first one is an earlier Tiny Tears. She is wearing a caracule
wig,
but it's made out of a lamb pelt.
Mm-hmm.
And so you can wash it and wash it. I know I had a tiny one when I was a child. And
you can see a short on that. Her body's made out of rubber.
Her body's made out of rubber. Now I'm going to show you, rubber deteriorates. So I've got this keeping her leg from collapsing,
mm-hmm.
because that's what happens to rubber over time.
You can see the difference in the color of
her.
This little lady has the hard vinyl. This right. little lady has the rubber. And her face is quite different than the other two.
This, which would be maybe only 2-3 years apart. It's there's not much.
So then you have come over here, and this little one, she has got a hard plastic head,
and
she has a rubber body. So she is closer to this one over here, but she obviously has a different looking face, and she has the Saran hair.
Yes, there's her Saran hair.
I think we ought to end our video, honey.
Oh, sure.
So we want to say that, we hope everybody is enjoying our videos. If you would like to like this video, we'd love that. If you'd like to subscribe and this is your first video, we would love to have you. We want to say that we really enjoy having those of you who keep coming back. And I think we made quite a deal that day when we found those four dolls, don't you?
Oh, absolutely. Look at her. She's got a lot of decades ahead of her,
mm-hmm.
being a hard vinyl and hard plastic. She's in excellent condition, can take a licking and keep on ticking.
So, are you ready, honey?
Sure.
It's that time of the video.
Just remember, it is possible to do it yourself.
Mm-hmm. Bye, everybody.
Bye-bye.